Welcome to Winnerton Creek, a place as witty and creaky. Yeah. I can't wait just to see that big cool statue that looks very funny. But of course, you, like always, have to kill this guy.
47. I've marked your map with several points of interest. We're running this mission with very little upfront intel. But these locations could provide clues to help you obtain the information we need. Good luck.
Oh, you're a police.
Not anymore.
Okay, wait, good. I can't see that. You can't see it unless you trip over it. Mm-hmm. Oh wow, they have magical windows. Ugh! A lawn chair, some beers, whatever that thing is, a tire and cage, crush can of beer. This place I want to go inside. Look at that! Looks cool, does it not? Looks great. Oh no! Screwdriver. Stabbed into a tree. I'll take this any day as long as it stabs. Stabbing is my main weapon in this game. Wow. That's a light. That's a cool. I can't reach it. I touched it. Totally. I got a wrench and a screw. Two things. I need the most. That's for the wrench.
Stop. Nova? Stop!
Oh.
Really? You know you don't have germs on your hands?
Kung Fu Panda.
They're not clean. You didn't just wash them. When's the last time you washed your hands?
That's how you kill someone. So you don't stab him. You go.
Hey,
what's wrong
with you?
Wait, that's not an ordinary resident of Whittleton Creek, 47. This must be one of Cassidy's men working undercover. I suggest you keep an eye out for more of them.
Huh? Is that ice? Isn't that just like ice? Doesn't taste like ice. Oh.
Man, affirmative. Bagging and tagging.
Oh my god. Okay, this could be my secret base. Oh. Put them up there. Right there. Big shovel. What a big... Huh. Let's go. All these could kill something. Yes, even a paint roller. Yes. Even something here. A pot. You need baskets. Everything in existence can kill you. Even this bag. For town max, man. Tapu-poo. Try best time. Whee! I'm free!
These are the best muffins I ever had. I'm supposed to meet a client for a house showing today, but I can't stop eating. Maybe you know him. Mr. Nolan Cassidy?
Can say that I do.
Well, he's interested in the Schmidt house down the road. You know, the one that police shut down after the, well, incident?
I'm not really from around here, so no. I don't know anything about that.
Ah, I see. Well, never mind. He can wait a little longer. I need to squeeze a couple more of these beauties down.
Huh? Isn't someone else supposed to be doing this? Hey, you! Did you really do this? You have to stop right now.
No. It was done to. How am I suspicious? I turned on something. Rest my arm real quick. That's how I do it.
Have a fun. Charles Blake the Third appreciates your support.
Whew. I'm not quite sure I'll have him. Best muffin ever. Not smoking. Good.
Vote for Blake at the upcoming elections. Excuse me, sir. Are you a registered voter?
Sorry, sir. You dropped something?
Excuse me, sir. Are you a registered voter? I'd love to tell you about a new candidate who might just change your life. Yes, sir. A total game changer here.
I'm listening.
Wonderful. Well... I'm sure you're aware that voting season is upon us again. And if you're anything like me, a recent immigrant to this fine country, the candidates this time around just aren't very... Use a trash can. Wonderful.
Man, we might have a
well,
situation.
I'm sure you're aware that voting over. Season is upon us again. And if you're anything like me, a... recent immigrant to this fine country, the candidates this time around just aren't very...
Anyone there?
Savory.
Answer.
But we have a man here today who is about to change all that.
I don't care much for politics.
That is exactly why Blake is out ringing doorbells today. He has no stakes in Washington. No connections to the establishment. No allies hidden away in lawless groups that pull the strings around the world. He's just a common man who decided that he wouldn't take it anymore. He's here to clean up, to give you exactly what you want, and to make sure the government doesn't stick its nose into everything.
Fascinating. How is he going to achieve all that?
By imposing restrictions and pushing crippling laws that will bind legislators to their desks for decades. His approach is simple. Give every one of those Washington-based desk jockeys so much work they simply won't have time to enforce the existing laws. And then, while they're busy looking through their fat law books, use his executive powers to undo the existing laws. It's a radical approach, sure, but quite effective.
And this Blake character, he's out here now, ringing doorbells?
Sure is. Why do you ask?
No reason.
Good on you. Be sure to vote come election day. And feel free to spread the word about Charles Blake III. Have a flyer. Read more about Charles Blake III and his politically flexible platform. Have a flyer. Charles Blake III appreciates your support. Here's a flyer for you. Mr. Blake has many important initiatives to share.
Give it to me.
Vote for Blake at the upcoming elections. Have a flyer. Read more about Charles Blake III and his politically flexible platform.
A waste of time.
A neighborhood barbecue.
That is Nolan Cassidy, former Secret Service agent and current Providence Herald. Cassidy is assigned to protect James.
It would be a good time to coax some information out of unsuspecting locals. But I find that once the food's been served and the beer flows freely, people are more chatty. I think we'll return once the burgers are served.
All right, boss.
Ooh. Idea. William.
Oh,
quick.
Geez, darling,
where's the gas canister for the grill? I have an idea. I know how to kill Nolan Cassidy, and the best way to kill him. Poison burgers. Okay. Because he said he's going to return when the burgers are served. What? Okay, thank you. Okay, I'm in the party house. Get a sober up real quick.
I'm just leaving.
Well, it's sort of a hobby
that never really takes off. I'm not sure I can find any. Hmm. Well, Janice next door collects all kinds of ancient memorabilia. You might have a roll or tape or whatever it is that sort of thing uses. I'm sure you can.
Delicious.
That's very good to know. Thank you.
Good day to you, sir.
It's a car battery. lights, fire extinguisher. Where in the attic? Wait, William, where?
I said not in the attic, I said the garage.
I know, I actually said attic. Oh, there it is. That's not really a garage, sounds like it's like. I got it.
Finally see you here. Listen, the gas on this grill is no
oh, wow. Will you look at that? It's good to know the kind and helpful people still exist.
Good to see
you. I have to start flipping burgers now.
Hi there. Care for a taste?
You'll have to tell me all your secrets before I host another one of these things.
Wait. You got me wondering though, Susan.
Thanks so much.
Sure thing.
That sure hit the spot, let me tell you.
I'm sure you already
know. You folks enjoy your weekend.
Proper introduction all the same. I'm Susan Wilson, and this is my husband, Richard. And we've only just joined this wonderful community. We are so glad you all can come out today. I always say nothing makes a person feel more at home than hosting their neighbors there. So I am grateful that you've provided us with that opportunity. Isn't that right, dear?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely, ma'am.
A little louder, hon.
Oh, right. Yes, just like Susan said, it's really great to be here with so many people, neighbors. People who are neighbors.
That's right. You know, Richard and I have done a lot of moving around over the years, but like they say, a rolling stone gathers no moss. And you know, the second we saw this beautiful
hello
town, we knew this was where we were.
Yes, you have wonderful all around.
Hi there.
So I'm going to stop prattling on and let you all
understood.
Strange.
Are you going to pick that up?
Curious.
Hey! Target is fist fighting.
Okay.
Down. Don't shoot my bald head. I like my bald head. Don't leave me alone, bald head.
When you look at all these painting materials.
Wake up! We got a situation here.
Good morning to you. And this is the morning.
Don't make this any worse. Come on out.
You must be a master, the weed twister. Maybe you should pick that up.
Get out here now. I won't hurt you. Man, you got me? I don't know what the outfit was, but it was the guy.
Let's get down to business.
Try to mess with me. Get your ass out here, nice and quiet.
Got nothing. Yes. My arms. Quite broken. But you see, I need to get into this place, the baddie's house. Oh, this just releases air into the house. Screwdrivers. There's a joint. There it is.
Janus is apparently engaged in a civil lawsuit with another resident of Whittleton Creek. James Batty, the plaintiff, wants Janus to stop his annual landing of a helicopter near the local creek. The lawsuit also mentions Nolan Cassidy and his unlawful surveillance around town. So Janus takes a helicopter trip once per year. I think we're onto something here, 47.
47? I think it would be beneficial to locate the unlawful surveillance mentioned in the lawsuit. Perhaps Nolan Cassidy's house would be a good place to start.
Muffin. Delicious. You need more signs than that, pal. Coyote urine. What? For you.
I love what they've done here, though. Clean design, but with a small touch of bohème. I bet you if we open the oven, it's never been used. And if it is, I bet it's Richard Wilson who does the cooking. Well, I suppose that's stating the obvious, as he's the one grilling outside.
Honey, you're rambling. I know I sound like a broken record, but these are good people. I think they're as normal as you and I.
Well, no, look, let me rephrase. Either they are as normal as myself, or out of their minds like you. We'll all get on famous. Now, shouldn't we go out and mingle?
Huh? What was that sound?
I accidentally broke something.
Can you hear me?
Nope, I'm deaf. Hands are wet, you know this trick? Glacier water.
But seriously, they are weird. Look at this kitchen.
I don't know how to cook eggs.
And don't tell me that it's because they just got it made. This is not.
Nope.
I even saw Richard talking to Dick. Ugh. Anyone who can stand talking to Dick for more than 10 seconds
so
must be
oils,
an escapee from an insane...
Be very careful.
Asylum. I know, I'm out of order. I shouldn't be giving the Wilsons a hard time.
Yeah.
I just like being paranoid.
Caps on that will
whoa, do I know you?
You're starting to piss me off.
You kill us a fuck!
Hey,
Dad. Where'd that come from?
Huh?
Where? When?
She literally just got back.
Yeah.
When?
But,
Whittleton Creek.
Whittleton Creek.
I brought some stuff with me. Called diatomaceous earth. I'm sure you know what that is, right? Diatomaceous earth.
I like being exhausted.
I would figure you being a science-y person.
Ow.
It's, supposedly.
I'll tell you wrong.
It's like, super old earth that has,
I could
so
show you the world.
Glass, but too small to hurt us unless we inhale it. But it's really good for, insects. And, it's safe for the animals. And you can actually cook with it. It's just the only thing is inhaling it. But it's supposed to be like really tiny pieces of glass, and then they walk through it. Supposedly it attaches to their body and cuts them up, and then they die. So I'm not 100% sure.
That one's quite better than these.
You always have to bring you something.
Yeah, I have love for you. Apparently, I got the wrong kind of apple.
Just another few blocks.
I couldn't really get them. But I got the delicious. And every one of them that had one except Jack.
47.
Jack Jack
I've marked your map with several points of
interest.
Yes.
We're running this mission with very little
okay.
Upfront intel. But these locations could provide clues
okay.
To help you obtain the information we need.
I was going to get the honey crisp, but I didn't know if that was too much. So.
Yeah, I don't really get like random things. Like, the skin's bitter.
Yeah, alright.
So, Nova, like, she took like 4 bites out of it and she's like, yeah, this is gross. And then, William was like, this is soft. I like hard apples. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, next time, I like the Honey Crisp, so I'll get that. I've never had, I don't know that I've ever had any of that.
I don't like the nails because they're a little smaller.
Yeah.
So, like, it's hard enough to get an apple, like a whole apple. So we tend to most of the time.
Right.
The whole
game.
It kills me. Stop it. What is that? It's a cat. You keep it said. That's a pig. It's Nova. Hey, Mom, look. It's Nova. It's Nova. You're on the ground, Nova. You're a piggy. You're a piggy. You're a piggy. Look at the TV. It's a pig. Nova. That's so annoying. Quit doing that. That's not my gun. Oh my god. To a place that I don't know where. No entry. Too dang bad.
Down.
My gun!
James awaits your attention.
You did it. Give me a break, dude. Stop doing that? Oh my goodness! I freaking give up. I'm about to throw this controller across the room. It would not stop. I'm going to get the chair back. I wanted to stand up. Because it's more comfortable for some reason. Because this chair is hard and uncomfortable. And the controller kept going. And going like, all the way over there. Like my arm was outstretched when it wasn't. I was like this. And the controller was like. Okay, you're all the way over there. You're a mile away. Jesus Christ. Ting Tong China. Racist jokes.
Something.
Okay, I get it.
Buenos Aires International Airport this morning.
I don't know how to use this, so... Ducky, my best friend, Mr. Duck. The pale duck, Mr. Ducky. And my modern lethal syringe is the most, world's most dangerous poison that exists. And my tuxedo and my gun. Great plan. Who do I kill? Diana Burnswood. What allegiance? Allegiance. Oh, legend. I don't know allegiance. Words. I'm not letting it go. It's now my child.
I make it. Mister.
We're actually playing a game, okay? Cancel. This beautiful place. Who's my target? You're gonna kill Diana Birdwood? Guys, I listen. Okay, I walked all the way over here. What do you expect? Mendoza.
Here, I got you an invitation, just like old times. Come find me when it's done. Good luck, 47.
She's old.
Like I said, we'll talk again when it's done.
I want to do something, look. Okay. I killed her! I just killed Diana Birdwood! Yes! Supposed to do that, and the mission failed. Mr. Ducky, Mr. Ducky. This one is perfect. Mang. Where do we get a rifle? Pew 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 pew. All it takes is one, two shots. Two shots, one for each. Each to the face. Immigrant Royce. Most. She had no eyebrows.
Chongqing, China.
Chongqing, China. And you know, Chongqing, Tongling, Pong Chongqing, China. Oh my no. Oh my no. Oh my no, I wanna go home. I don't want this job no more. Oh my no. Where are the people who are actual NPCs? Oh, they are. What do you know?
What was that?
Twas me, madame. Twas me. Killed two people on the train station already. I like your shoes very much, man. You have very nice shoes. They're sneakers and they're very cool. These are a real pair of Vans. They don't make you run as fast as a van, but they're still a shoe brand. Yeah. Bye bye. Have a sweet death. I love the sound of glass breaking. I'm also holding you. Put you away. You're my guy and you're special. My chest orb. Away! Yep. I don't have a cell phone. Trying to punch when you really get a punch. Must it.
Hey! What the hell?
Shh. Have an apple. What you know about rolling? Oh yeah. Mustard. This is my phone. Apple phone. Quiet, Mr. Sneakers. What you know about rolling down in the a Chongqing bros loading. Bobby, you killed my wife a pretty bad. Gun physics. You know, all these people have advantages. They have nice pants, a nice jacket, a nice shirt, and a nice hat. But you shoes. These! What are these, dude? This is not for the outfit. I guess I was, they weren't lying when I said I look like a homeless person. And this outfit's. It's decent. It's lots of people you wear this outfit. High five. Oh, look at these clocks. These shoes, man. Well, I mean, you got the best shoes in the world. They broke in. That's how they died. I will go like this.
No.
Oh, no. You...
I'm below. Chong ching ching ling ling pan ling ling.
Gotta find him.
It's a good guy, I presume. Hi, I'm Chen Ting. Pleased to meet you. I'll be your guide on the facility tour.
Spare me the pleasantries. I've had an awful flight. 9 hours delayed, luggage lost somewhere along the way, and the airline is trying to avoid the risk. I'm hungry and I'm tired, and I want to straighten everything out before I'm doing your tour.
Yes. So sorry about your flight. Just let me know when you're ready. Oh, did you bring the P-41 we left for you in the apartment?
No. I wasn't informed that I should.
Oh, very sorry, Mr. Pritchard. We need you to bring the P-41 to get the tour. It's procedure. Please pick it up before you come and find me. I'll be waiting by the stairs in the back of the restaurant kitchen. Through the kitchen. I'll be waiting for him in the back.
Understood.
Hey, hurry up. The man is starving.
Yes, I'll see to it.
And he's like, I don't know.
Fucking whatever.
Well, it's not mine.
It's not yours.
It's not the kid.
How am I supposed to focus when the kitchen feels like a train station?
Find your inner zen.
It's Leah.
Why?
Is she behind Aunt?
No, I'm not meeting him at the apartment.
It's my favorite series. What other energy drink? That's what I drink. What other energy drinks have y'all seen me drink?
That's what I'm
doing.
What a dork.
No.
Zach, yeah. There's a calming bonus.
That's an observation.
Whoa.
Yes.
Hey, are you all right, buddy? Thank the heavens, you're alive.
No. I'm finding a knife. Rice, rock solid rice. Rocky rice. Come on, drop it. Thank you. We're making a mess. Some more here. Damn, what is that? How? So it seems clean. All perfect. Now I'm actually going to be a kitchen chef. Heard me, right? Of course you have. I've killed literally everyone in Antarctica. Secret.
I don't know, new management. This doesn't taste like it. Used to.
I don't know. It tastes like it's
huh? Bye-bye. Go. In the bathroom. The poison. Oh my god, the poison was right here. Look at my running skills. Ain't nobody know about this. Whoa.
Jeff out there.
Yeah.
Don't get up. I don't move. Hold the phone. Fuck it. So, I was really hoping she wasn't going to do what she's doing. So, all weekend long, you know, she sent me, like, I read to you, like, the random messages, right? And she sends me a message. I'm heading out now, or I'm leaving now. I'll let you know when I get back. So now all of a sudden she's letting me know where she is and what she's doing and all. Exactly, right? So I'm like, so I messaged my therapist. I literally just sent her a huge paragraph of how Chrissy's, you know, decided that reassuring me isn't going to help me at all. You know, because I need to be able to self-soothe kind of thing, right? So, and how I'm feeling extremely confused by her motives or whatever the case might be. And it just so happened that, like, why would she do that for this weekend? She's supposedly doing whatever it is that she's doing. She sent me a picture to prove the point, you know, of the schedule. And then she sent me a picture of them all in a group and stuff like that. And I'm like, she's not supposed to be reassuring me, so she, you know, so she sent me that picture to show me that she was with them and that she was at the beach and whatever the case might be. And so now all of a sudden that she's away from all of her people, now she's up my ass sending me messages. And I'm like, on one hand, she was in the moment and focusing on what she was doing, right? I can see that point. But I have a horrible habit of going through our Verizon account and looking at who she's talking to and who she's messaging ever since all that shit happened, right? Well, she's texting every fucking buddy and their brother while she's there, except for me. So I'm like, okay. And then she messages me and she's like, so, do you think you can come over tonight or tomorrow? And I'm like, I don't know, because, and I messaged Brett to tell her, like, I am not a space filler, I am not a boredom filler, whatever, I'm not here, I'm her wife, I am her partner, I'm supposed to be, whatever, you know, that kind of thing, and she's not treating me that way until she has no one else to talk to. Exactly. So I'm like, I don't know how I should feel, but like, I'm not allowed to talk to Chrissy about how I feel. Because if I do and it causes an issue, then we're going to be back to like not being able to talk to each other at all, right? So I'm like, I'm sick to my stomach right now with the way I feel about how she's talking to me, and I'm like, I literally feel like she has taken my mental health into her own hands by saying, I'm going to do this because you need that, and that kind of thing. So instead of allowing me to work on my things in my time, she shoved me out of the nest. I'm a fucking bird, she shoved me out of the nest, kind of thing. And I'm like, the only thing that's going to do is push me farther away. Because if I put that wall up so I can protect myself, I'm probably not going to get back through it because of the way I feel. Mm-hmm.
So. Wait, what if I make it back to the old spot?
But yeah, so I'm like, now she's talking to me about this, that, and every other thing. And I'm like, I literally said, you don't need to tell me where you're, when you get or go anywhere, but thank you. And I will not, and she's getting medicine from her mom for me. And I said, I don't need those for a week or so because this is what happened. She's like, can we hang out tonight or tomorrow? And I said, I don't know. She said, oh, okay, well, maybe next weekend, I guess. Okay, you want to fuck around and find out? You know, because obviously, remember she was supposed to come back to me and talk to me when she could focus on what I said to her? She never said a word to me, right? And I said, okay. And she goes, well, whenever you're available. I said, we can make a plan for next Sunday. She said, okay. And I said, pencil me in. And she goes, will you be seeing Kane at all this week? This is what she does. This is how she manipulates me to get me over there. She's telling me that I need to see Kane, kind of thing, right? And yes, I want to see my son. I want to see my daughter as well. But I don't need her to, you know, like, let's, you know, so she told me she's not going to schedule, she doesn't need to schedule time with me and this and everything because I'm her wife and whatever. But that's exactly what she has to do, right? And she's like, I said, or she goes, I don't need to pencil you in. We've already had this conversation. I was like, I don't know. She's like, alrighty then. I said, I have some issues that I need to work on. Because you want me to fucking not worry about you, then I'm going to do it. Then I'm going to fucking do it. I'm done. I can't, whatever. She goes, I'll let you know when I get home so you can pick up your medicine at some point. I was like, I don't need you to let me know. I don't need you to tell me anything. Like, we're planning to hang out on Sunday because I'm not going to be at your beck and call. I am not going to be your little bitch. I'm not going to be your, I'm not doting on you. That's exactly what I'm not supposed to be doing, right? So, I just don't. So that's just how I feel. Damn it. I think her telling me, reassuring me was the wrong idea, or whatever it was that she had said, like I feel like turning my location on was the wrong idea, kind of thing. I ended up leaving the, like, 360 group, because I'm just like, okay, that's fine, I won't see where you are. So I'm in one with Kaya, and I sent her to Killian. I don't need to be in a group with her at all, if that's how she feels. But then she's never going to know where I am either, so that's fine. Yeah. Right now she doesn't seem to care, but...
Closer when you were and everything.
Yeah. The color of the camera video is inverted.
You stay away from the turtle.
Thank you. So we've got the...
Don't eat the turtle.
That's not...
Probably better that you don't have your nose where it belongs because you won't be able to smell or stinky farts anymore.
My nose goes either.
Oh, right, it's a blue.
Orange.
stinky, stinky fart.
That's not where my nose goes.
Okay,
where does my nose go?
On
your
cheek.
No, it doesn't go on my cheek. No, it doesn't go on my other
cheek. I finally passed the level!
Where's my nose go?
No.
No, you're playing on that computer.
No.
No.
I got
your chin.
No.
Why y'all can't play on anything, because y'all destroy stuff.
I can go that and they end next to our computers and leave trash around our computers. Someone left trash around my computer yesterday. I don't want to play on it.